a little drama that thrilled Nickelodeon audiences when the movies were young. Waldo McSnurd may not be the richest man in town, but he certainly is the tightest. Right now, he's suffering from a severe attack of DDTs. In short, Waldo is plastic. Not even the pleading of his wife, Myrtle, has any effect. He insists on going out to look for a weekend he's lost. Although things are tough, Waldo keeps his gin up. But the strain on Myrtle has been too great. Something has snapped in what is laughingly called her mind. With subtle pantomime, she indicates she's going to run away with her young daughter, Blanche. My grandma, what big eyes you have. After hours of wandering, mother and child hit the hay. But Myrtle's eyes are actually bigger than her stomach, so she wanders off in search of food. It isn't long before Hiram, a kindly farmer, finds the deserted child. Hiram and his wife decide if no one claims Blanche in 30 days, they'll keep her. Little Blanche, now played by beautiful Blanche Sweet, has grown to womanhood. In fact, she's introducing her fiancé to her foster parents. And who is she engaged to? Horror of horrors, it's Waldo McSnurd, her own father. Egad, what a quirk of fate. The wedding party leaves for the church, and who should wander by but Myrtle? 20 years is a long time to wander. She's a little tired. Farmer's wife goes to get the exhausted woman a glass of root beer. But now Myrtle's eye is attracted to a picture she seems to recognize. A picture of Waldo, her husband. She learns that he's just left to marry the little girl the farmer found 20 years ago wearing a shawl. The girl, not the farmer. Joyfully, Myrtle recognizes it. But slowly it dawns on her that one and one cannot make two. Now Myrtle really gives out with what they once called dramatic intensity. She must get to the church before it's too late. Blanche looks lovely in her giant jello mold hat as the ceremony begins. Myrtle arrives in time to give the groom away. Get a load of Waldo's reaction. Myrtle dies, Waldo repents, and Blanche faints as flicker flashbacks rings down the curtain on the usual happy ending.